Hello again, friends. This is Alex, and today we are going to do the bottom of the body. We have Junior the Jellyfish looking oh so happy right now, and with his beautiful flowery bottom. And what we're gonna do is make a circle to go around the bottom here to seal in the stuffing, and then we're gonna work on the tentacles. And so I'm just gonna set Junior right here, but I want to make sure that his yarn is separate, so I'm gonna set it up here. But I want him to be in camera because he's such a cutie. Alright, and then what I'm gonna do is start on the body, the bottom of the body. So first we're gonna do a magic circle. There we go. Okay, we got our magic circle, and we're going to make 10 stitches into this magic circle, just like we did at the beginning of Junior the Jellyfish. So here we go. This is 1. Feels weird starting from something so small again. So that's 1. And we'll do 2. 2. So we got 1. And we'll do 3. Might have made the same mistake I made on the first time, which is not leave enough tail. Alright, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Definitely didn't, but we'll see if we can make it work. 5. A big stitch. Let's just make sure we got 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. This is 7. This a little bit to make 9. Let's double check. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Perfect. Okay, we have 10. And now we're going to increase in each one. So I'm going to pull this a little tighter. Not too tight, because I want to be able to get into that first stitch. Looks like I pulled it pretty tight. Nope, it's okay, it's right here. So I'm going to go into this first stitch. Pull this taut. Oh, wrong one. Pull this one taut. And increase one. And then we'll do it again. Increase two. Okay. I'll put our stitch marker on that first increase right here. And then we go and continue making the bottom of the body. So, increase one. Increase two. Increase one. Increase two. Increase one. Increase two. Increase one. Increase two. Keep bumping Junior a little bit. Looks like we might have split the yarn there, so I'm going to go back one. Should be increase two. Yeah, this should be increase two. But we can make sure. We just have to have an even number of stitches on this row. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, okay, that was increase 1. So let's go back again and not split the yarn. Okay. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, well now I count 9, which means that we need to do increase 2. So, I think we were correct. Alright, then increase 1. This is the really big stitch. Increase 2. Increase 1. Increase 2. Increase 1. Increase 2. Oh, increase 2. Lost the stitch there for a second. Increase 1. Increase 2. And last 2. Increase 1. Stitch marker is getting caught in my fingers. And increase 2. So let's make sure we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Perfect. I'm actually going to take my jacket off real fast. gonna reposition Junior. Okay, so we did 20. And now we're just gonna do single stitches for rounds 3 and 4, and that's all we're gonna do. So let's do that now. We can also pull this tighter now that we've made our second row. So I'm gonna pull this taut. There we go. It's easy to see, it gets so taut. And it like spreads back out as the as it gets pulled on a little bit. So that's okay. So we're gonna start our single crochets here. Single one. I'll put in our stitch marker. There we go. Single one. Put in a stitch marker. Okay. Then single two. And we don't have to count all the singles like normal. I just got back from a really nice dinner with the family, even though it's not Thanksgiving. No, it doesn't have to be Thanksgiving to have a nice dinner with your family. A little surprised that we're doing single crochets in each of the increases, because I expected it to be more circular rather than, you know, this is gonna make kind of a bowl again. Okay, so we did 20. And now we're going to do 20 more. That's one. Put in our stitch marker. And we begin again. That I'm gonna have to take a break in December. Maybe I'll have some videos queued up by then, but I'm taking a vacation. So I won't be able to crochet for about 2 weeks. And of course that means no videos for 2 weeks. Which is fine because we have a lot of content already. I definitely want to, of course, finish Junior before before then. I mean, we might even finish... No, we won't finish Junior this video because we have to make 7 coils. 7 tentacles. And I don't see us making all 7 because they're 60 chain long. Each one. So, I don't see us doing that. But in less than 30 minutes, that is. But we might get 1 or 2 done. I need to make sure that I remember how to chain properly. I'm so used to stitching it around that chaining is gonna be weird. Okay, we're coming to the end of round 4. One more. Oops. One more. Here we go. Okay. And then we need to fasten it off. Leaving a long tail for sewing. So I think we're gonna sew all around. So I'm gonna pull this through. That is a very long tail for sewing. I'm gonna tighten this again. And then I'm gonna do the flip inside out. And the idea is that this should go right over the bottom like this. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Like that. And I'll sew that on. I don't think I'm supposed to sew it on quite yet. So we have 2 pieces now. Oh, well, it is a... Wow, I did a really long tail. Okay, we have 2 pieces. And the last things we need is to chain 60 . Okay so if I remember how to chain 60 correctly, which I'm not 100% sure, I think you just make a slip knot like so. But let's make sure. Have it in my handy dandy notebook. And chain stitch. I don't know if my loop is correct here, so I'm going to do what they say, which is do this. They say make a little loop like this, and then pull this through, so it looks like this. Oh, well, I didn't. Oh, I made a critical mistake. of, needs to be like that. And now I pull this, I'm pretty sure I did this correct the first time, but I'm just going to follow the instructions just in case. Yep, and then we have this, I pull it tight, pull it up tight against this. Okay, and then it says the slip knot is down the hook, yarn over, draw hook yarn through hook, loop on hook. Okay, so we just yarn over and pull through. Oh, okay, that was pretty easy. Yarn over, pull through. That's two. How am I going to count up to 60? 3, 4, 5, 6. These are getting larger and larger. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Oops, I twisted the yarn a little bit there. 36, 36, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, almost there, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60. Okay, we've done the chain 60. Now we have a very long chain. Goes off the camera. Let's flip back to our instruction booklet. And it says, increase in second chain from hook and all remaining chains. Increase in second chain from hook. Okay, so not this one. How do you do that? You just go under. Or is it in between this stitch? I'm confused. Is it like, you can't go underneath both stitches? It's gotta be like this, right? Okay, so let's see if this looks correct. Maybe. Maybe. Okay, then we'll do this one, increase one. Increase two. Okay, I'm not sure. These are supposed to be coils. Okay, so we did that one, so. This one now. Increase one. Unless this is not the way that you're supposed to do it, and. In which case, I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure. I'm not sure how else you would do it. But this is just like the front loop of a stitch. So we'll do one like this, and if it doesn't look good, in between this and, oops. I think this is making a mess. I'm going to pause the video and look up how to properly do this. Because this is not chaining correctly. So, let's just make sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 59, so I'll do one more. Okay, 60. Okay, I'm gonna pause the video here. And actually, it looks like we're about a minute or 30 minutes in. So, that might be a little short. Anyways, I will say, let's end this episode here. And I will come back with more knowledge about how to do the coils. So, thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you all next time.